What's up, geeks, and welcome to the channel. Finding the shortest path between two vertices of a given graph is a classic yet a fundamental theoretic problem known in graph theory. Dijkstra's algorithm is one of the many algorithms out there that addresses this problem, and it's the subject of today's video. I want to start by telling you where this algorithm is actually used. So, some of its applications are social networking, finding the shortest distance from point A to B on maps, IP routing to find the first open shortest path, etc. Okay, let's take this weighted directed graph as an example. We can clearly see that the shortest path from A to D is A, B, C, and then D. Now, what Dijkstra tells us is that if A, B, C, D is the shortest path from A to D, then the shortest path from B to D, for example, must be B, C, D. Or the shortest path from A to C must be A, B, C. In other terms, any sub-path B to D of the shortest path A to D between vertices A and D is also the shortest path between vertices B and D. Dijkstra uses this property to backtrack the shortest path in the opposite direction after overestimating the distance of each vertex from the given starting vertex. To make things clearer, let's take this positively weighted directed graph and the starting node A. Now, before we start exploring all paths in the graph, we need to initialize all the nodes with an infinite distance and an unknown predecessor, except for the source node we picked, which will be assigned a distance of 0, as the distance from node A to node A is 0, obviously. Keep in mind that the core idea of this algorithm is to continuously eliminate longer paths between the starting node and all possible destinations. So, we are trying to find the shortest path between A and all other nodes of this graph in this example. To keep track of the process, we need to have two distinct sets of nodes, settled and unsettled. Settled nodes are the ones with a known minimum distance from our source, the ones where the minimum distance and the predecessor are filled and finalized. The unsettled nodes are the nodes we can reach from the source, but we still don't know the minimum distance that separates them from that source node. Okay, the first thing we need to do is pick the node with the lowest known distance and then evaluate all its unsettled adjacent nodes. The idea is to add the edge weight that separates our source from its adjacent node to the source distance, then compare it to the destination's distance. Example, for node B, 0 plus 2 is lower than infinity, so the new distance for node B is 2, and the new predecessor is A. The same applies to node C. Node A is now considered settled. Nodes B and C are added to the unsettled nodes because they can be reached from the source, but we still need to process their adjacent nodes and make sure that the distances we picked are indeed the minimum. Now that we have two nodes in the unsettled set, we choose the one with the lowest distance, in this case node B, then we reiterate the same process until we settle all nodes in the graph. So, next we check the adjacent nodes of B. Let's take C. And as you can see, the edge weight from B to C added to the minimum distance of B is bigger than the previously evaluated distance of C. Therefore, the distance of C we had is indeed the minimum. After repeating this process on all the available nodes, we will be able to calculate the minimum distance and path from A to all of the graph nodes. Okay, let's go ahead and try to implement this algorithm, and I guarantee after this, things will be way clearer. To find the optimal path between the nodes of a graph, we actually need nodes or vertices. So, the first class we are going to create is the node class. This one will house the name of the node, in our example A, B, C, etc., the minimum distance of that node, which starts off as the integer.max value in order to simulate infinity, a map storing the adjacent nodes of that node and the edge weight separating them, and finally, a list storing the shortest path from the source node, which will be later updated by the Dijkstra algorithm. To help us with the implementation, I added two helper methods, the addAdjacentNode method, which takes a node and the edge weight separating them, and I overrode the compareTo method. This was done because we will be making use of a priority queue to poll the unsettled node with the smallest distance. I also made use of Lombok annotations, and if you have no idea what these are, I will leave a link to our video on Lombok in the description box down below, feel free to check it out and all that stuff. Okay, on to the Dijkstra algorithm implementation. The first thing we previously did and are going to do now is set the distance of the source node we picked to 0. Next, we are going to create the settled and unsettled sets we talked about. The unsettled set will actually be the priority queue, and the source node will be added to it right from the start. So while this queue is not empty, what we are going to do is poll the node with the minimum distance from it, and then we are going to loop over its adjacent nodes. More precisely, for each adjacent node that isn't settled, meaning we still don't have a decisive minimum distance for it, we are going to update that node's distance and shortest path via the evaluateDistanceAndPath method, which we will be implementing in a sec. And then we will insert this node in the queue of unsettled nodes. After we loop over all of the node's adjacent nodes we polled, we add the node, the one we are currently working with, to the set of settled nodes. Okay, let's take a look now at this evaluateDistanceAndPath helper method we made use of inside the for loop. We previously mentioned that we need to compare the sum of the edge weight and the distance of the source node it connects to the destination's distance. And that is exactly what we are doing here. Now, if the distance calculated is smaller than that of the node we are trying to reach, then we found a smaller, a more optimal path linking this node to the source. So, we update the distance and the path to reflect what we just calculated. To update the path, we just add the node we are currently at to the path at hand. And that's it, the Dijkstra algorithm implemented in Java. Let's go ahead now and test our code. To do that, I created several nodes and added a distance between them. The result should be similar to the graph we were working with at the beginning of the video. Then, I called the calculateShortestPath method, providing it with the source node, in this case node A, and finally, I called the sprintPath helper method to display the shortest path attribute of each node we passed to the Dijkstra algorithm, as long as their minimum distance. As you can see, the result is the path from A to each node in the graph we created, and not any path, the shortest path, alongside its corresponding shortest distance displayed next to it. So, that's it for this video. I hope it was helpful. Thank you guys for watching. Take care, and I will see you in the next one.